in the Pacific between Japan and America would be decided by who controlled the small home islands that were used for air superiority. Securing the island of Iwo Jima was critical for the United States. Once the United States was able to control the air, they would eventually be able to win the war in the Pacific. No army in Japan's 5,000-year period had successfully fought on Japanese soil. Confronting Iwo Jima would be the first time America would attack Japanese soil during World War II.
Japanese was fighting in Manchuria and China all those years, and they were night fighters. They weren't fighters during the day. They came out at night.
Japanese ruled the Navy field against America in the early 1940s. When America found out about this, they decided they wanted to strengthen their Navy for when they would encounter Japan. Then, Japan found out about what was happening with America's Navy. Shortly after, the Japanese planned a surprise attack on Pearl Harbor to prevent America to strengthen their navy. They killed many sailors and destroyed many ships. Japan fought to the death against overwhelming odds during the last year of the war. It was the most immensely indestructive point in the war. But then America came into play with Japan.
People of us in the military, there were 160 million people in the United States, and everybody was paying attention to what was going on in the war.
Iwo Jima, an 8-square-mile Japanese home defense island, where nearly 7,000 Marines lost their lives for their country.
There were 28,000 people killed on 8 square miles of land. That's 3,500 dead bodies per square mile. It was a horror. It was a terrible, terrible battle.
This battle is one of the biggest battles in World War II, therefore making it one of the biggest turning points in history. The Japanese general, Tadamichi Kuribayashi's strategy for his men was to kill 10 Americans before they got killed. He also told them never to surrender, to fight until their death. It was the Japanese war strategy to never be taken prisoner.
No matter what, they wouldn't become prisoners. They didn't have no part of that. That was failure. They wouldn't surrender. They go fight until they die.
The main objective and strategy for the Marines was to capture the island, and more specifically, the airstrip of Iwo Jima.
Well, the objective of taking Iwo Jima was to have a place for fighter planes that they could go escort B-29s over Japan.
On February 19, 1945, over 500 convoy ships traveled to the island of Iwo Jima and transported 70,000 Marines. This battle was the longest armada of the war, with 10 miles of battleships. 20 men were on each Amtrak, in 10 waves of quickly moving towards the beaches of Iwo Jima. When Marines arrived to the island, frustrations occurred. Volcanic ash made it very difficult for the Marines to pursue up the mountain and through the island. Marines were not able to dig down far enough to get protection from gunfire or mortars.
The only way you can move out there is you either crawled from one bomb crater or shell hole to another in order for protection. Some of you got up and ran.
The first day of the battle was a very successful 24 hours for the Marines. They successfully covered 1/3 of the island in the first airstrip. They thought they would have it easy, but they still had 35 more days of gruesome fighting that was coming, and they had no clue. American troops started to advance towards the Iwo Jima airfields and to the base of Mount Suribachi. They needed to capture the mountain, and this was the first attempt to advance towards it. Satchel charges and flamethrowers took care of Japanese soldiers entrenched in the mountain. The Marines rarely even saw a Japanese soldier because they were all in pillboxes, caves, or behind rocks. To that effect, the Marines used hand grenades and flamethrowers to their advantage.
All around you, there was talking and moving. Only hand grenades you trusted, one after another, said Dr. Gentile. The Japanese used mortars as a great advantage against the great forces of the U.S. soldiers. Since they were wide open, they were sitting ducks. Covert leader had an experience with the mortar, he says. I was watching an Amtrak to the side of us as we went in. Then there was this enormous blast, and it all disappeared. Everything just vaporized. American advancements moved towards the north and south side of the islands. Japanese kamikaze pilots flew airplanes into American ships out in the Pacific. The carriers Saratoga and Bismarck Sea were damaged and sunk. This had a great effect on the battle. Iwo Jima was the longest, most intensive shelling of World War II. It also was the longest aerial offense of the war. The Air Force dropped napalm and bombs throughout the whole island. But sadly, it had little effect against the Japanese soldiers, since they were mostly underground. Mount Suribachi was the most heavily fortified area on the island. We gained control of the mountain on the fourth day of battle. As American troops reached the top of a mountain, six men raised a 60-pound pole, and Americans finally had hope. The second last day of the battle, Marines finally secured the final airfield. But unfortunately, the hills surrounding the strip were occupied by Japanese troops. Soon the Marines' main objective was completed, but there was still much blood to be dealt with. Evacuation arrived at the island quickly, and the next day, they declared a victory on Iwo Jima. It was the best day of the 36 days of battle on Iwo Jima. Marines lay by cheering and crying as 250 Japanese corpses lay near the U.S. infiltrated lines. The battle is over. They have secured the island and the airfields of Iwo Jima. Now they can finally obtain airfield close to the mainland of Japan. This was the only battle where the U.S. had more casualties than the enemy. The U.S. Marines had a total of about 26,000 casualties, with over 6,800 dead. Of the 21,000 Japanese soldiers, only 216 survived. They were all taken prisoner. After the battle, monuments and gravestones were set up on the island, with most of the buried troops that died because of the battle. It was the saddest part of the whole battle to see how many gravestones were on Iwo Jima. So why was winning the Battle of Iwo Jima such a big turning point in history? Well, the truth is, because of winning the battle, we won World War II. When we secured the island, that meant we had control of the airstrips. Then we could send and recover B-29s returning from Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Securing the island also prevented any kamikaze pilots to reach America, since we controlled the air from Japan to Hawaii. This was when we knew we won the war. This here is the most famous picture in history of war. Joe Rosenblatt took it on the fourth day of battle of Iwo Jima on Mount Suribachi. It is the most remembered moment of World War II. A statue was made only shortly after this picture was taken to symbolize the Marines that fought for us in Iwo Jima. This is the bronze statue that was made from the famous picture. As Vice President Nixon said, "This statue symbolizes the hopes and dreams of America." When American citizens saw this picture, it was a symbol of the end of the war. After the bombing on Japan, Japan's Prime Minister met with American President Harry Truman and the SS Missouri for a formal surrender from World War II. To that effect, we won the war.